Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com. In today's video, let's implement dark mode in your app as simple as... If you are interested in building out this project with dark mode, then make sure you keep on watching. Hit that subscribe button, open up Xcode, and let's dive in. So let's take a look at what we are going to build out today. Well, basically we are not going to code that much, but you will understand how to use light and dark mode with colors in SwiftUI. So I have just run this code, SwiftUI dark mode, and if you want to take a look at the full code, go ahead and click the link down in the description to get access to all of this nice UI layout in SwiftUI. But today's topic is dark mode, so that's why we said that dark mode rocks here. And if we go to settings here, and let's see, if you just scroll down to developer and select dark appearance under the appearance and go back, you will see that indeed our app has a dark mode reflection here. Okay, so how do we actually get this? Let me just go back to white mode again. Go ahead and take a look at the current version of the app, current appearance of the app. And once I just go into light appearance, let me just go back there. And as you can see, all of the colors have changed, the background color on the icon here. So we are going to dive deep into this today. And if you feel like it, go ahead and take a look at this awesome content view. And what you need to know here is that you can actually get the color through its literal name. And here we have accent, and here we go, accent, and background shadow, and again, a background shadow. And as you, let me just show you what these colors are. Okay, if we just open up this, you will see that under appearances, we have in this project any and dark. And here we have our any appearance color and our dark appearance color. But by default, if you create a new one, let me just create a new color set here. And I will name this test. Okay. And as you can see, it's universal, of course, because of the devices, but under appearances, it says none, okay? Because this is just a default value. It doesn't really support, right off the bat, light and dark mode. Okay, so to change that, just select any or dark or any light and dark. Now, what's the difference between any dark and any light and dark? Well, basically, any means iOS 13, prior iOS 13, and light is the default value for iOS 13, and dark, well, it's not the default value, it's the default light appearance and the default dark appearance. So if you choose any and dark, then any on iOS 13 will be the light mode by default. Okay, so that's the gist of it. And yeah, I have created for the other colors any and dark, but let me just go here and select any light and dark. And as you can see, all of them are now white. But if we wanted to, we can change the light appearance here and then the dark appearance. Okay. And how to use it? Let's just go into the content view. And for the foreground color, let's use this test. And this will change the foreground color of that card that you will see in just a moment here. There we go. It's bluish, just like this one. Okay, let me just show you side by side. Okay, and if we go and select the dark appearance, then you will see this awful brown. Okay, so let's revert that. Let's go back, hit Command C and use this accent color. Now, if we just scroll a little bit down here, you will see that we have this foreground color of primary for the moon circle image, and the secondary is the foreground color for our text. Now, this is also selecting the current appearance of the device automatically. What I mean by that is, let's just build and run again, and you will see that the moon circle system named image is this one. So it's white now, but if I just go ahead and select the light appearance, you will see that now it's black indeed. And the same goes for our secondary color of our text. Now, this is useful because, yeah, maybe you just don't want to tweak your colors in the assets catalog. You just want to use the primary and the secondary. It's useful for titles, subtitles, and so on. Okay. Now, if you do like dark mode, go ahead and comment down in the comment section below with hashtag Rebeloper and your opinion about dark mode. Throughout this video, we learned about implementing dark mode on iOS and custom colors in Xcode 11. But I want you to hit the notification bell, because in my next video, I'm actually gonna talk about MVVM in SwiftUI. If you're interested, make sure you hit the notification bell so you don't miss that video. In the meantime, while you wait for that video, make sure you also check out these two videos that I have over here. I talk a lot about iOS development, SwiftUI, and how to code better. So make sure check out these videos as well.